Welcome to Southwell Minster and to the fourth in our series of organ recitals from the screen organ. If you haven't seen the first three, do go and have a look. And please subscribe, turn your notifications on, like, share, comment. It's lovely to see how many people have been watching so far. I'm really touched. Thank you so much for watching. Well, tonight's recital features exclusively the music of J.S. Bach and only two pieces. The first is a trio sonata. He wrote six of these, and this is the first one, and in fact it has been requested. A trio sonata is really normally an instrumental piece, and by which I mean it involves wind or string instruments, normally two melody instruments with what's called the basso continuo, which is more than one instrument, but it's playing one part, normally a bass line with some harmony. Well, this technique of playing three parts simultaneously obviously transfers quite well to the organ. We have a right hand, a left hand, and some feet, and one part can be assigned to each of these divisions. The sonatas themselves generally have three movements, and this first one really sets the mould, a little bit like the Italian concerto of the time. And the first movement is lively, the second movement rather slower and more thoughtful, and the third movement of this particular sonata is really, really exuberant. It's a bit of a test of the organist's coordination and skill and concentration and stamina, and I do apologise for any mistakes that you might hear along the way. I can't really blame these on the page turns. What I can blame them on is the fact that this is really very difficult music, particularly for those of you who don't play the organ an awful lot these days. Nevertheless, I hope you enjoy it. I love it, and there's really no excuses to be made. The second piece is Bach's monumental Passacaglia and Fugue in C minor. 2 years ago, we had the first organ recital, evening organ recital, or late afternoon as it was, as part of the Southwell Music Festival, which would in fact be starting this week on Wednesday. And it's a real shame that that can't be happening this year. So 2 years ago, we had the first afternoon organ recital as part of the festival. And I was really privileged to be asked to give that, again, exclusively the works of J.S. Bach. And that recital finished with the Passacaglia and Fugue. Now, a Passacaglia is a form of variations. And you will hear at the very start a theme played out in the pedals of the organ. So it stays in the bass line for quite a lot of the time. But there are 14 variations that follow. And each of them has its own little character and its own little moments. And sometimes the theme is very obvious and often in the bass. Sometimes it moves around into other parts and indeed almost disappears altogether. And it's a really good game to see if you can still hear what's going on. Well, not content with 14 variations on this 8-bar melody, Bach decides a fugue is necessary as well. But this is no ordinary fugue. This is what we call a double fugue. Now, fugue is a compositional technique, really. It's not a form. And it involves a theme being used in various different ways, and involves playing around with different keys. There's actually quite a set way to do it. A double fugue involves doing this twice. So the fugue theme you will hear goes a little like this. That's the first half of the Passacaglia theme. There's also a counter melody that sits with it. So every time you hear the main theme, you will also hear that counter melody. But because this is a double fugue, that counter melody is also a main theme. And so alongside, you also hear this. This is the first time it appears in the tenor line. It sometimes starts in different ways, but the main body of it is the same. This is incredibly clever composition, and Bach was an absolute master of this sort of thing. And all the parts are written so that they can appear in any different combinations, in any different order, treble, alto, bass, tenor, it really doesn't matter. Very clever music. But most importantly, it's extremely musical music. It's full of depth of feeling and a real sense of communication. And of course, that's what music is all about. And it really is an extremely dramatic piece. I hope you enjoy it. Again, it's a huge test of performers' stamina and concentration. And I do apologise again for any little blips that there are along the way. Entirely performer's error and nothing to do with Bach whatsoever. Well, lastly, I do hope you enjoy this recital. And if you do, please consider making a donation. All of the information is on the Minster website and everything is gratefully received, particularly at the moment when income is severely limited. And I'd really like to mention a gentleman whose name is John Cooper Green. He is the organist of the parish church, St. John's, in Keswick, in Cumbria. And every year during August, John plays a series of recitals on a Sunday afternoon, and they are, again, exclusively the works of Bach. And this has gained something of a following in Keswick, and it's really wonderful to see people there having cups of tea, doing their knitting, and just enjoying the music. And I'm so pleased that I was able to attend the first of these in 2020, which happened on Sunday the 23rd of August, a few weeks later than planned. And this is what really inspired me to do a complete Bach recital, and I might do another one or two along the way. Hopefully at some point you will also see my colleagues. They're currently on furlough, but I know that they are really hoping to be able to share some of their playing with you. So thank you once again for listening. This is really just a window into me playing the organ in the evenings, but I do hope you enjoy it, and come back for the next one. Thank you very much. Thank you.